I'm Rudra. I'm practicing cardiologist at Moradabad. Today I want to speak about the prevention in coronary artery disease. As we all know, coronary artery disease is the number one killer in India, and the incidence of this disease is increasing by day. In contrast to West, the patient population here which is involved in this problem are quite younger. Usually the patients are, we are getting very frequent patient in the third or fourth decade of their life. This is the period of their life where patient himself and his family are in mid of their life. The expense of treatment is borne by the patient by himself in most of the times, because insurance cover is very low. As the cost of treatment is very high, many of the time patients find themselves in a soup. And in fact, according to one survey by NCAER, that is National Council of Applied Economic Research, the major cause of indebtedness in rural India is cost of treatment, because many of the time patient borrows the money for treatment. In Indian scenario, we are getting the patient in the third or fourth decade of their life, and their first presentation is usually MI or heart attack. This is in contrast to the West, where the first presentation is usually angina, and then two occurs later in age, that is the fifth or sixth decade. Third or fourth decade of the life of the patient is very crucial, as he is in the midst of his career and his family is also in a difficult stage, in a sense his children are small, and many of the time the patient is the sole breadwinner of the family. Keeping all these things in mind, in our mind, we should devise a strategy where we can decrease the load of this disease in our population. And the best way out is prevention. And prevention is not very difficult. If we stick to certain principles, then we can definitely decrease the disease, this disease burden very effectively. There are certain risk factors in cardiac problems. If we are able to control those risk factors or eliminate altogether, we can definitely come out of the problem. These risk factors, as we all know, are smoking. If we quit smoking, it is said that the patient who smokes and quits smoke, he increases 10 years of his life. If the patient is diabetic or hypertensive, he should keep his problem under control by drugs and physical measures. Third important thing is exercise. One should do moderate level of exercise for at least half an hour a day for whole of the week, or at least 5 days out of 7 days a week. Moderate level of exercise means brisk walking for half an hour. Brisk walking means the patient should walk about around 3 kilometers in half an hour. It is also very important to stick to a good diet. Good diet means we should avoid the foods having trans fat, like the common snacks which eat, like samosa and namkeens and matris. They should be avoided. They should be taken occasionally. Sugar should be avoided. Earlier, it was thought that only the fats are the responsible for the development of coronary artery disease. Now, lately, it has been recognized that refined sugar is also very important cause of coronary artery disease. So, consumption of refined sugar should also be limited to not more than 5 to 6 teaspoons a day. We should have at least one third portion of our diet in the form of raw vegetables like salads. Eating hours should be fixed. We should have a good breakfast, we should have a good lunch, we should have a good dinner. But the dinner should be at least 2 hours before the sleep, and it should be light. If we stick to these broad guidelines in our daily life, we can surely decrease the burden of the disease, and we can lead a very healthy life. That's all.